you get your things together, you get the little bit of a... The cats have been playing with the set here.
There we go.
So, getting yourself set with a strap and two blocks and a blanket. Today, we're going to start with the oil first. If you don't have the oil, rub your palms, right? And this is the presence oil from Monara, and you can use this going forward to keep developing this energy, because you've mapped this alignment of energy and oil and truth and expression, and they're all one thing. So when you don't have time for this practice, you use this oil and this energy is available. So firstly, right at the heart center. Settling, feeling for a shift. The heart center, the center where the base body meets the higher body. And letting go. Oil to the middle finger, the right middle finger goes to the left base of the wrist, the space between the crease and the bone. That this throat energy is the space where we ascend into the abstract, where we step beyond the plane of Maya, where we go beyond what we can see and feel and taste and touch, what we can imagine, what we can name. Change sides. And in that naming, we are so powerful. And so we want our naming to be potent and clear and sound. And to do that, we leave behind the physical body. We prepare it. We tend it so well that in perfect health, our body disappears from our awareness. And then we get sick and it takes over. And we get a splinter. And we get a pimple. You know, and the physical body suddenly flares up as the center of our universe. Change sides. And yet, so the thumb at the base, in between the two tendons, the middle finger, the base of the wrist. When we attend to our physical body and it transcends itself, when the bliss of being this limited being joins with the infinite being that we truly are, we meet at the heart. We must attend to our physical selves so that we can transcend our physical selves. Right wrist, thumb, middle finger at the back, holding. Each point sanctifying the physical body so that we can be more. So our words relay the more, the transcendence, rather than the sense-based limitations that we are also familiar with. Let us rise into the imagination, what can only be known, spun by words, the power of the poet and the novelist. And from there we begin, palms together. May our energy be elevated. May our expression be elevated. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. We are guided outside and in three times. Amen.
Om Namo Gurudev Namo.
I surrender. Emily, we are right here with you. Hands and knees, cat cow. Cat cow. Round the back, tuck the chin, drop your head, hug your tail. Let your hips move from side to side. And then drop the navel, heart forward, and then head down. Inhale, open, exhale, round, take your time. Until the movement of your spine begins to determine your breathing. Turn your left thumb forward, try to draw your hands apart. You can work there, turn your left fingers back towards your left knee. Cat cow, open through the hand, open through the forearm, the left side collarbone, the left side throat, the left side kidney. 5, 4, 3, 2. Good. Turning your fingers forward. Right thumb turns forward, right fingers turn right. Try to draw your hands apart. Working there, opening the base of the neck, the front of the throat, or turning your right fingers back, opening through the palm and the forearm and the shoulder and the right side jaw and the right side kidney. Turning it forward, child's pose, open and close your hands, free your wrists. Hands and knees, tuck toes, down dog, that's your exhale. Hands and knees, that's your inhale, and return to child, that's one. Hands, knees, breathing in, down dog, breathing out. Hands, knees, breathing in. Child's pose, breathing out. One more time. Starting to open through the arms and the shoulders, meeting child, give it a breath. Inch your fingertips forward, open the armpit. And then we'll all meet in downward facing dog. Bending your knees, lift your heels up high. You're springy. And as though pressing out of the racing blocks, press into your feet, press into plank, high plank. Pull back into that springy bent knee posture. 5, and back. And 4, and back. 3, 2. Excellent. In your dog, walk your dog, one heel and then the other. And step your right foot up outside of your right hand, left knee down. And put a block under your left hand, a big back circle through the right for 3. And for 2. Letting your hips move, letting your shoulder move, beginning to feel a connection. Now only your hips. Right arm stays, broadening through the shoulders, reaching through the fingertips, and pause. Reach your right hand up and back. Your palm is open, your right thumb rolls to the right, and it rolls to the right scapula under your heart. Your chest is broad, and let your hips come forward. Drop the pelvis. And then sweep forward, setting down, stepping back, down dog. Be aware of the right thumb, all the way up to the right outer hip, all the way down to the right inner heel.
how the breathing changes, opening the right side of the diaphragm. Left foot steps up, right knee comes down. The block is underneath your right hand, and the left hand back circles for three.
For two. The body holds the past, holds what you've been doing, where you've been. And now only the hips. And to come into the present moment, we help the body release where it's been. The tension, the tightness, the walk of yesterday, the carrying of things. And as we clear it out, we can truly set it down. Set down what we've carried. And the left hand goes back, and the palm turns open, and the left thumb turns open, and the left shoulder blade under your heart, broadening your chest, broadening under your tongue. Hips drop towards the left heel. And sweep the left hand up, over, and down. Base of your left thumb down into the floor. Outer hip up and back, left heel. Inner heel coming down. So you're a spiral of movement. And let the breath open as the back of the diaphragm on the left side starts to change. Good, walk your feet up. Hands go wide, roll your thumbs up to sit your seat down, to stand up tall, to hands up high. And thumbs to your heart, land in your heels. Rinse it out, inhale, reaching. And knees bend, fold down. Left foot steps back, left knee down, hands come up high. We'll go three rounds, inhale up. And then exhale down. Step back down dog. High plank, pull forward, look forward, bend your knees down dog, draw back. And the left foot steps up and the right knee comes down, and there's no hurry, and there's no force. Trust the postures to do their work. Step your right foot up. Hands go wide, sit down, thumbs up, heart up, stand up, palms to touch, thumbs to your heart, sit it down. Pause. Inhale, go. Inhale, up. And fold. But each time we move, we're being rearranged. Right foot steps back, right knee comes down. Hands up. And fold. And down, up. That each thing that's happening to us is for us. High plank, like a posture. And sometimes the posture is uncomfortable. Down, dog. Right foot steps up. Left knee comes down and uncomfortable because it's unfamiliar, it's not what we thought. And down. Stepping up. Hands wide, sit down, thumbs up, heart up, stand up. Palms together, land. And start from here. Start now. Inhale up. And fold. Left foot steps back, left knee down, fall up. Surrender and fall down, and they serve you. Step back. How little do we need to do? High plank and we float. Down dog, but what once was onerous and challenging, we float. Left foot up, right knee down, and right. And fall. Stepping up. Hands wide, sit down, thumbs up, heart up, stand up. Thumbs to the heart. And let go. Rise up. Follow your breathing. And fold. Right foot back, right knee down. Rising. And folding down. Step back down up. Move to plank. Bend your knees back. Right foot up. Left knee down. Hands up. And sit it down. Stepping up. Hands wide. Sit down. Thumbs up. Stand up. Palms together. The quiet that you're creating. Stay. And let go. Weight into your left foot, right knee kind of go free. Left hand high, go two. Firm your left leg, lengthen your left toes. Right hand high, stay. Right foot goes back, hands counterbalance, forward, high lunge, toe to the floor, hands up high. Left hand holds your right wrist, go up, go left. Lift your right thigh, open the front of the right hip. Releasing, lean forward, counterbalance, right knee to your chest, stand tall, breathe in, hands to your hips. Bend down. Right heel to the floor, left knee high, interlace your fingers to start, make a crease. And as you crease the thigh to your body, press your right heel into the floor, lengthen into your toes, right hand high. Left hand high. Forward with your hands, back with your heel, find your balance, drop your left toes to the floor, high, lunge. Right hand holds left wrist up and over to the right. Lift your left thigh, open the left ribs, abdomen, waist. Upright, release your hands, lean forward, draw your left knee to your chest, stand tall, hands to hips. Set down, hands high, open wide. And then fold to the floor, stepping back, down dog. And feel the length, the freedom that you're starting to make in your body. And that makes for length and freedom in your breathing. Right foot steps up, left knee comes down, a block under your left hand. Let your right knee fall open to the right a moment, and right hand to right thigh, hips come forward. So right knee goes right, I'm on the outer edge of my right foot. That can be step one, it can be awesome, letting your hips come forward as you can. Or if you're going on, right foot flat, right hand high, take it back, open the palm the way we did before, open the collarbones, or catch the top of the foot, outer ankle, stay for three. Wrapping your shoulder blade under you wherever you are. Wherever the legs and hips are, the heart can go higher, the throat can go wider. The crown of the head is more accessible. And release, hands down, step back, down dog. Notice your base of the right thumb, outer right hip, inner right heel. Left knee is soft. Right shoulder wraps in and under toward the heart. Base of the right first finger into the floor. Clarity and purpose through your body. Left foot steps up. Right knee comes down. Right hand to the block. So let your left knee fall open. Come onto the outer edge of your left foot. So making space, a little pressure into the left hand, helps the hips come forward. And that can be perfect. That might be exactly where you stay. If you're going on, bring your left foot flat and your left hand high. And your left hand back, palm open, as we did before. Thumb opens, heart lifted, or bend your right knee, catch the outer foot, stay for three. And as you deepen your breathing, where can it go? Where can the posture invite change? All the way up into the mouth, into the top of the head. And release, left hand high, sweep it forward, step it back, base of the left thumb, outer left hip, inner left heel. Right knee is soft, right side is soft, left side is diligent and clear. Walk your feet to your hands. Bring your hands to your hips. Unfold, sweep wide, a little quicker. Hands down the backs of your legs. Exhale as you fold. Hands up the backs of your legs. Inhale as you rise. just flushing out the front and back body too. Inhaling up and exhaling down. Hi, one more. Fold. And this time, unfold, coming up tall, interlace your fingers, press your palms to the ceiling, and make little circles. Ha! From the soles of your feet, draw a circle with the palm of your hand. Ha! Through the hips, through the ribs. So we've moved forward and back. We've been linear, make a circle. And then reverse. Feel it through the mid-back, feel it through the chest. Three, through the waist, two. And then reach your hands wide. They meet behind you, interlace your fingers, knuckles down, and just stay for three. So that when you let go and your palms face forward, you can notice a new current. Now the subtle body is waking, mobile, moving, hands high. Fold it down, we'll step back, we'll meet in dog feet.
So that the upper body is a little open to match the lower body, bring your knees down,
hands to your hips, keep your toes tucked under, hips forward, tuck of the chin, inhale, lift up. I exhale, tuck it down. So the elbows are back, the shoulders are low. You may work there or walk the hands down the backs of your legs. Your fingers point down towards your knees. And in this position, you are supporting yourself through the core rather than through the hands. And then just explore. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Doesn't need to be big, just lift your chin and set it down one more time. Excellent. Come into your dog. One more standing pose, hips up and back. Notice now across the chest, the throat, how the energy, how the opening is moving up through your body. The postures are deliberate and skillful. Feel the breath at the very tops of your lungs. Bring your feet together and raise your right foot high. Let your left heel be heavy. Let your knees be soft. And just explore where you can go into the ankles, into the knees, into the hips. Let your knees bend and straighten. Turn your chin. A little mobility. And step your right foot up between your hands. Left heel to the floor. Warrior two. Open wide. And stand. Left hand drops back. Right hand comes over. Straighten your front leg. Little wriggle. Little up and out of the front hip. And warrior two. And side angle, bring it across. Left heel to the floor, left hand is long. And then reverse one more time. Keep your front knee bent, left hand back. Feeling that space of camel you were just in, knees to the floor, chest broad, heart high, all the way into the root of your tongue. Lift your eyebrows, widen your eyes. And then cartwheel it to the floor, right hand, left hand, step back, down dog. Feel the right thumb, right outer hip, right inner heel. Feet together, and the left foot high. Bend your knees, play with it, bend, straighten. Lift your heel off the floor, bend your elbows, press into the floor, press into your hands, and then step your left foot up. You are pliable and strong. Warrior two. The asanas are a reminder. And reverse, right hand to your thigh, straighten your left leg, wag your tail. Notice how grippy we can be in reverse warrior. Let it go, drop that. And then warrior two, bending the knee with new length, with new approach. Elbow to the side, right hand over. Plug into your right heel. Left knee left, you're broadening the pelvis. And keep the broad pelvis, keep the base, warrior two. So you built something, don't lose it. And keep the base as you reverse and let it hold your heart. Let it broaden your throat into the mouth. Let it widen your eyes. Let it be a little fresh, a little frisky. Left hand down, right hand down, step back. Base of the left thumb, outer left hip, inner left heel, find the line. And breathe through that left side. You have a blanket folded in half and sit wide-legged. So you're seated on the edge of the blanket, the heels go wide. Mm-hmm. And you move from side to side. Unless there's someone residing on your blanket. How different the body is. So we move through the physical asanas, not to be attached to the asanas, but to use them to allow the physical body to open, to be accessible, to carry their message, to remind us of our stability and our balance, how pliable or how inflexible we might be. Right hand stays down, left hand comes up over. Use your right hand to turn your left ribs back and sit your left hip into the floor. And from there, the tiniest bend of your right elbow toward the floor and up and out. Just a little pulse for three. Each time your elbow bends, you get a little longer. Sit your left seat down too. Roll the left ribs back. Open the left side of your spine. And then up and over, left hand down. Palm to the floor, right hand comes up over. And notice that we tend to collapse. So use your left hand to roll your rib back. Roll your chin towards your right shoulder, and then with that rolled open rib, a little bend in the left elbow, and a little return. As you bend your elbow, sit down into the right hip. A little bend, a little straighten. See where it goes. You can shake out your right foot, your right knee, all of this is connected. And upright, put your fingertips to the floor in front of you. Draw a circle in your seat. That we are coming unstuck. Reverse your direction. Into the hips, into the spine, through the chest. Three, two. And as you pause tall, bring your legs crossed and notice the height of your spine, your mouth corners, your readiness to be still. Left hand, thumb, first fingertip, touch, yin mudra, find that, set it down. Making order, sweeping the room, clearing the counter. Spine tall, heart a little high, chin a little in, navel back and strong. Right hand, fingers together, thumb apart, put the tip of your right thumb to your right side nostril. Just above and behind the flare of the nostril where the bone begins, close there. Inhaling, you'll come in through the left. When you're ready to exhale, just softly release the thumb and exhale through both. When you're ready to inhale, close the right side. So in left, out both. Start to smooth it out. counts in, three counts out, or four counts in, four counts out. Becoming symmetrical. As you breathe in, adding on a sensation of awareness and attention, bringing energy up the spine on the inhale and out both nostrils on the exhale. Tune into the stillness at the center of this breath. End of your next exhale, right hand comes down. Continue inhale up the spine. And then exhale white light into the spine. Find that before you move. And take it with you. Light in and up the spine. Exhale white light to the spine. Keep it with you as you come to child. Knees wide, palms together, elbows down, head down. Inhale up the spine. Exhale, white light into the spine. And then up, adding red at the base, orange low belly, yellow navel, green heart, blue throat, indigo, forehead center, and violet crown. Inhaling through those colors and exhaling white light.
Finish your isolation. And then walk yourself up into your cross-legged seat. Those colors are the frequencies, the different aspects of our lives moving from the most dense, the slowest, thickest experience of matter, up into the quicker experiences of thought. And the white light is the integration of all of it, that we are all of it. Keeping that right axis through the center, the hands go wide, the thumbs turn back, the palms are open, turn your chin up. Bend your elbows, turn your chin right. Inhale as you turn to the left. And then exhale as you turn to the right.
One more time. Hands high and go 3/6 inch and up. Tuck your chin and cap that energy. Lift the pelvic floor. Lift your attention up and through the spine, that white line, that Sutra Atman, into the midbrain, into the pituitary, into the physical balance. Chin up, breath out, hands down. We would change our chemistry. Our functioning, our well-being, and our sense of ourselves, until it is so transcendent in us, through us, we move beyond it to know self. That truth begins at the throat, that abstraction. And so we activate the abstraction, which is very exciting to think about, build kneeling. Here we go. Last time. You know what to do. If kneeling is not your jam, don't kneel. Otherwise, set yourself up. Thumbs point up, thumbs point away, palms are open, heart is up, chin slightly lifted, This is your modification. Start here. Open your mouth. Close your mouth. Same breath out the nose. Or extend the arms. Lastly, pinkies touch. Chin points to the fingertips, chin slightly lifted. There's a little pressure at the base of the skull. Up and out of the physical body, up into the conceptual realms, into the frequency of thought, rather than the frequency of matter. Up and out beyond the physical self, into the infinite soul. We go. And for today, you're going to keep the breath going, release the hands, interlace behind you, knuckles down, heart high, chin lightly in, hands float away, keep the breath. Seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Inhale, chin up, 3, 6, go. Tuck your chin, lift your hands, stay for 3. Stay for 2. Let it go. Release your hands, release your chin, release your breath. Hands on thighs, let go, and ride, transcend, ascend. I am this, and the truth is revealed to me, and my frequency is quick and free. And my frequency at this point matches your frequency at this point, and my self dissolves and meets yourself, and we are ourself. And this is the same self as the stones, and this is the same self as the sun, and this is the wave, and this is the current, and this is the ocean. Liberation. And find your seat. And you're just going to coast into your kundalini kriya. You're just going to coast. You know where you're going. You are supported. Spine is tall. The last two fingers fold down, held by your thumb. First two fingers fold together. A very, very stable mudra. Elbows wide, fingers touching, height of the throat, so simple and steady. Heart a little high, chin a little in, navel drawn back, seat is strong. Eddie. Notice your inhalation for 3, pause it for 5, and let it go for 10. If you run out of breath, 5, then just hold the exhalation. Just stay empty for 10 and then let it in. It'll get there. No rush. Move on. 2, 3. Pause. 2, 3, 4, 5. And out. And in. And pause. Keep rising. Settling into the spine. Continue. Let it become intimate and personal and very kind. There's a subtlety here. You are familiar. Find the subtlety. settling into your seat, into your stillness. Or unfolding entirely, rest in your shavasana. Deepening your exhalation, releasing even the stillness of the shavasana. And let your hands go high, wherever you are. Interlacing your fingers, a little circle in the chest. And then hands, the shins, walk your feet in. Let the knees open and close. Bring your palms together. Rub the soles of your feet. And then hands to the shins to roll your way up into a simple seat. Sweep your hands wide, eyes tall, gathered in this. And then right down the middle, this bright axis, this scene of homecoming, your hands high. Palms together, thumbs to the forehead center. I bow to the all the great truth of myself. Long stop, short note, inhale. Sat Nam. Namaste, I see you. Thank you for these 40 days. I will be back on Sunday with a new sequence. And I'll be back on Sunday with a big announcement about a new offering for the fall. You and I have been building something so substantial, especially if you've gone through last year, that year of you, the journey through the chakras, really getting established and clear and strong all the way along. And then we've had this year to explore. This fall, we have an opportunity. I feel a great call. There's another level that's waiting and that we are ready. And I don't often offer the more advanced work because I really want to make sure that we're ready, that we're safe, that we're strong, that we're sound, that this won't kind of blow a fuse. Because I've had that done to me and I don't appreciate it. But I know there are those of you listening that are so ready. And so on Sunday, we will talk about what comes next. And this won't change. We will continue to have these 40 days going forward, which is fantastic. And then that's the jam that works for you. There it is. And if you want more, because you feel ready and you feel called, there's more coming. There's another level. Just want to make sure we're all there. Thank you. Happy Vishuddha clarity and strength to you, and I will see you on Sunday at 8 a.m. 7 a.m.